In this course, I'll be using VirtualBox to make a virtual machine that runs Ubuntu Desktop. You can get the files you need from virtualbox.org and ubuntu.com, or you can use any Linux distribution you prefer. Let's take a look at the process of setting up a virtual machine. Depending on the speed of your hardware, this could take up to 20 minutes or so. Here's the VirtualBox website, and I can click on the big blue button to download the current version. There's a few different options for the platform. So if you're using Windows, click the Windows one. If you're using a Mac, click the option for that one. And if you're installing VirtualBox on Linux, click the Linux distributions one. Take a minute to download and install the software on your computer. Then head over to ubuntu.com, where we can download the Ubuntu installer or ISO image. This is a pretty big file, so I've already downloaded this on my computer. But you'll want to take a few minutes to download it. Mouse over Downloads, and choose Desktop. You'll need the file to be completely downloaded before you continue. Then click the green button. Once you've installed VirtualBox, open it up and you'll see the Manager window. If you want to find out more about VirtualBox, take a look at my course, Learning VirtualBox, which focuses on how the software works and how to use it. Let's build a virtual machine. I'll click on New, and I'll give my machine a name. In this case, I'll call it Ubuntu Desktop. Make sure the type is set to Linux and the version is set to Ubuntu 64-bit. Then click Next. VirtualBox recommends 1024 megabytes of memory. Ubuntu will run with that, but it's not a great experience. So I'll give my machine 2048, or 2 gigs, and then I'll click Next. I'll choose to create a virtual hard disk, VDI type, and dynamically allocated. VirtualBox recommends 10 gigabytes, but I'll change this to 80 gigabytes instead. This space isn't being taken up yet, so it doesn't really matter. But I like to give myself a little bit of breathing room, and I'll click Create. Then I'll click on the virtual machine and choose Settings. Under Storage, and then the empty slot under the IDE controller, I'll click the CD icon over here on the right, and then click Choose Virtual Optical Disk File. I'll go to my Downloads, and choose the Linux installer image that I downloaded earlier. Then I'll click OK. Now I'll start up the virtual machine. I'll maximize the window. I'll click the button to install Ubuntu. Then I'll go through the setup process. This has identified my keyboard as US English, and that's correct, so I'll press Continue. And then I'll continue through this screen with the normal installation, and I'll tell the installer to download updates while it's installing. I'll click Continue. Because we're installing in a virtual machine, we'll erase the entire virtual disk and install Ubuntu. I'll click Install Now. Then I'll click Continue. The installer's found my location, so I'll click Continue again. And then I'll create a user. I'll type in my name, and then I'll provide a password. This is the user that I'll use to log into the system. I'll press Continue. And now the installer will finish installing Ubuntu. When the installation finishes, I'll click Restart Now. I'll click my name, and I'll type in my password. And I'll click Next through the Getting Started screens. I'll put my virtual machine into full screen mode. To do that, I can click here in the menu, or I can use the host key and F. The host key on this system, which you can see down here in the right corner, is Right Control. Now I'll go up to Activities and start to type Terminal. I'll make the font bigger with Control Shift Plus. And I'll choose View, Full Screen. Then I'll go through the process to get the exercise files. I'll need to grab the Git software package and install it. Don't worry about what this command does right now. Just follow along and type in sudo apt install Git. If you see an error, make sure that the software updater application isn't running. Press Y to continue, and the Git software will be installed. Now, type git clone git://github.com/scottsimpson/command-line-basics. Those are downloaded now. I'll go into my dash by pressing the Windows key or the Command key on my keyboard, and I'll choose Files. I'll open the Command Line Basics folder and move the exercise files into my Documents folder. Now, we're ready to get started. I'll click back on my terminal and then go to Edit, Preferences. Here, under the Colors tab, I can change the colors for my window. I'll uncheck Use Colors from the System theme, and I'll change to Tango Light. You can set your colors however you like. And then I'll choose Close.